please be encouraged to stay with God. And that's what I'm going to be talking to you about on today. Stay with God. Stay with the Lord. Don't leave him, but stay with God. Oh, yes, stay with God. And don't be fooled. Don't be fooled by the enemy. The devil wants to deceive you. He will tell you that you cannot leave God. In other words, the devil will tell you once you get saved, you will always be saved. So you can get saved and then hypocrite and do whatever you want to do. You can never leave God because the enemy will tell you that it is once in and never out. But I'm here to tell you that that is not true. That is not true because there is such a thing as backsliding. Now, in order to backslide from something, you must have been in it. You see, you can backslide from the Lord. Yes, you can. You can leave God. But don't leave him. No, don't leave God. If you are saved, please do stay saved. Stay with the Lord. Oh, yes, stay with him. Keep on living for the Lord. I encourage you to do that. Yes, you keep on living for God. Keep on fasting and praying. If you haven't been fasting and you haven't been really praying, well, start back fasting and praying. Hallelujah. You keep on praising God. Well, if you haven't been really praising him lately, you start back praising the Lord. Keep on worshiping him and reading his holy word. Don't get weary in reading the word of God, but you keep on reading his word and holding on to the Lord. No matter what you may be going through, stay with God. Stay with God through the good times. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And through the bad times. Because if you stay with God and God is with you, you shall receive eternal life. And that is what's most important, having eternal life with the Lord. But the enemy doesn't want you to know that. The enemy wants you to leave the Lord. He wants you to give up your salvation by turning your back on God. But don't do that. If the enemy has put in your mind to turn your back on the Lord, don't you do that. Don't turn your back on God. No, don't give up, but you stand. Hallelujah. Oh, yes, you stand. Hallelujah. Though the enemy may, hallelujah, turn up the heat on you and come against you real hard, but you continue to be encouraged in knowing that you don't have to fall, but get God's word. That's right. Get the word of God and read it. Hallelujah. Read it for yourself. Study God's word and believe his word. Believe God's word. Believe whatever the word of God is saying and then apply it. Apply God's word to your life and rejoice. Hallelujah. Rejoice knowing that God will see you through. And stay with God. Stay with him. Don't leave the Lord. Don't walk away from God. You see, if you can't make it with God, what make you think you can make it without the Lord? Because you cannot make it without God. You see, you need the Lord in order to make it in and receive eternal life. And eternal life is what's really important. It's so important. The cares of this life is not what's really important, but receiving eternal life is what's really important. You see, what you are going through down here, it is only temporary anyway. And sure, there is nothing wrong now with wanting to be blessed in this life with natural blessings. There's nothing wrong with that. But don't put natural blessings before the spiritual blessings of God. But put God first. Regardless of what you may be going through, put the Lord first and not last in your life. Let the Lord be second to none in your life. Oh, yes. Oh, yes. It might get rough sometimes. You see, sometimes you may have to cry. You may get discouraged sometimes. You may feel like you are all alone. You may feel like no one cares, and you may feel like you are in this thing all by yourself. But lift your head up and be encouraged. Stay with God. Don't leave Him. Stay with Him and seek the Lord about it. Whatever it may be, seek God about it. Don't backslide and don't commit suicide. That's right, I said it. Don't commit suicide. Because sometimes when you're going through really strong storms is in your life and you're really going through hard trials and tribulations, the devil might try to put suicide in your mind and try to convince you to commit suicide. But suicide is not the way out of your troubles. No, it is not. And don't let the devil convince you that suicide is the way out, because it is not the way out of all of your troubles. Instead, suicide will lead you to a burning hell and not to heaven. Suicide will not lead you to peace, but it will lead you to eternal sufferings. If you commit suicide, you're not ending your sufferings. It's only the beginning of eternal sufferings. So don't commit suicide because you are having troubles and sorrows, because suicide is not the answer. But Jesus, hallelujah, hallelujah, Jesus Christ, He is the answer. Just look to the Lord and He won't let you down. You see, the Lord, He will work everything out for you if you would only let Him. And just because you may be going through the storm, that does not mean that God does not care about you and your situation. But instead of giving up having hope in God, you need to come to the Lord all the more and give it all to Him. Let the Lord handle it for you. To those who are saved, be encouraged out there to stay with God. Be encouraged to stay with Him. And to those of you listening to the sound of my voice who are not saved, be encouraged to come on to the Lord. Yes, come on. Come on to Jesus, because Jesus Christ is so soon to come. We are living in the last days, and it is wise to live for the Lord, for we don't know the day or the hour that Jesus is to come, but it will be very wise to be ready when Jesus comes. Yes, you may have sorrows and cares in this life, but one thing about it is joy in the Lord. Hallelujah. It is joy, unspeakable joy in Christ Jesus. If you are looking for peace of mind, He can give you peace of mind. He can give you joy and love and everything that you need. The Lord, He has it. That's right. He has it. And He can do it. Oh, yes, He can do it. I am going to give you some scriptures. 1 Peter, the 4th chapter and the 12th verse says, "Beloved, think it not strange concerning a fiery trial, which is to try you as though some strange thing happened unto you." In Philippians, the 4th chapter, the 8th and 6th verse, the 7th and 4th verses says, "Finally, brethren, whatsoever things are true, whatsoever things are honest, whatsoever things are just, whatsoever things are pure, whatsoever things are lovely, whatsoever things are of good report, if there be any virtue, if there be any praise, think on these things. Be careful for nothing, but in everything by prayer and supplication with thanksgiving, let your requests be made known unto God. And the peace of God, which passeth all understanding, shall keep your hearts and minds through Christ Jesus." Rejoice in the Lord always. And again, I say, rejoice.